inshallah ta'ala. Today, inshallah ta'ala, I want to speak about when Allah commands something, subhanahu wa ta'ala, the commands of Allah is categorized into two. When Allah commands something and He tells you to do something, it's two types. The first type is talabul fi'l, the requesting of you to do something ala wajh al-ilzam, in a forceful manner. You have to do it. And the second type is talabul fi'l ala wajh al-afdaliyah. You're requested to do something in a recommended manner. It's not obligatory, but it's a recommended manner. And these two that I mentioned, the first one is called wajibat, and the second one is called al-mustahabbat. Wajibat means obligatory, and the second one which is recommended, that which isn't obligatory. In our sharia, the wajibat, jinsul wajibat, afdalu min jinsil mustahabbat. The obligatory acts are better than the voluntary act. Whether it be salah, whether it be fasting, whether it be any other act, jinsul wajibat, the obligatory acts are far greater and better than the voluntary act. And this is based on the hadith in Sahihain min hadith Abi Hurairah, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, وَمَا يَتَقَرَّبُ إِلَيَّ عَبْدِي بِشَيْءٍ, that my slave doesn't remain getting closer to me, بِشَيْءٍ أَحَبَّ إِلَيَّ مِنْ مِمَّ افْتَرَضْتُهُ عَلَيْهِ, more beloved to me than that which I made obligatory on him. So this hadith clearly and categorically, what does it tell us? That the thing that Allah loves the most and that is more pleasing to Him is what? That which He made obligatory on you. And then the hadith says, وَلَا يَزَالُ عَبْدِي يَتَقَرَّبُ إِلَيَّ بِالنَّوَافِلِ. Then the hadith mentions that if you come with a voluntary act, it will increase the love of Allah for you. Allah's love will increase for you, or for the slave. But the beginning of the hadith tells us that the obligatory acts are far greater and better than what? The voluntary act. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He has obligatory acts and He has voluntary acts, some of those which are at night and some of those which are at daytime. And some wajibat are at what? At nighttime. And some of the wajibat are what? At daytime. Also the voluntary acts, some of them are what? At nighttime, and some of them are at what? Daytime. ولذلك أبو بكر بن أبي شيبة, he mentions in his مصنف that Zubayd, he said, لما حضرت أبا بكر الوفاة, when Abu Bakr was on his deathbed, أرسل إلى عمر, he sent a letter for Umar, meaning he requested for Umar to be brought to him. فقال, then Abu Bakr said to Umar, إني موصيك بوصية, I'm going to give you an advice, a farewell advice. In hafiztaha, if you say, memorize this advice and you hold on to it, then a lot of good is going to come for you. What is the advice that he gives him? He says, "Inna lillahi haqqan fil layl." Allah has right at night time. La yaqbaluha fil nahar, which Allah will not accept at daytime. Allah has rights which are done at night time, He will not accept it at daytime. Wa anna lillahi, and that Allah has حَقًّا فِي النَّهَارِ, has right at night, daytime. لَا يَقْبَلُهَا فِي اللَّيْلِ, which he will not accept at night. Then Abu Bakr went on to say, وَإِنَّهُ لَا يَقْبَلُ نَافِلَةً حَتَّى تُؤَدَّى الْفَرِيضَةِ, and that Allah does not accept a voluntary act unless the person comes with the obligatory fast. A person who's not praying Dhuhr, Asr, Maghrib, Isha, and Fajr, praying Qiyamul Layl is what? Is wrong. Allah won't accept it. Is the Salah sahih if you pray Qiyamul Layl without praying Dhuhr, Asr, Maghrib, Isha, Fajr? Is it sahih? Na'am. It is sahih. Because the conditions are met. Lakin is it maqbool? Is it accepted? No. Because Allah only accepts it when it's done after the obligatory has been done. The nawafil and the sunan, one of the virtues and one of the goods that it has is that if you're deficient in your wajibat, it completes it for you. One of the good things about it. And that's why the person should increase in how much voluntary acts that they do. Because the voluntary act, whether it be fasting, whether it be praying, or whether it be any other act, it will complete if you're deficient in your obligatory act. And Imam At-Tirmidhi and Abu Dawood and Nasai and Ibn Majah and Ahmad and other than them narrated min hadith Abi Huraira that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, أَوَّلُ مَا يُحَاسَبُ بِهِ الْعَبْدُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ صَلَاتُ. The first thing that the slave will be accounted for the Day of Judgment is his what? It is prayer. فَإِنْ أَكْمَلَهَا. If he completes his prayer, then it's good. وَإِلَّا. And if he doesn't, قَالَ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ. Allah says, أُنظُرُوا. Look. لِعَبْدِي مِنْ تَطَوُّعٍ. Does my slave have voluntary acts? Does he have any extra righteous deeds? تَطَوُّع is a what? Voluntary act. فَإِنْ وُجِدَ لَهُ تَطَوُّعٌ. If it's found that he has voluntary acts, Allah says, أَكْمِلُوا بِهِ الْفَرِيضَةِ. Complete the voluntary with his obligatory. And then this is the virtue of what? Of coming with the voluntary prayers, like قِيَامُ اللَّيْلِ now. If you're deficient in your salawat, this will complete it for you. وَلِذَلِكَ حُذَيْفَ سُؤَيْمَان. Praying. And when he prayed to him, he said to him, مَا صَلَّيْتَ. مَا صَلَّيْتَ. He said, you did not pray. And then he asked him, how many years have you been praying like this? And the man said, أَرْبَعِينَ عَامًا. 40 years I've been praying like this. So if the person comes with voluntary acts, it can actually complete for you the deficiencies that is in the obligatory act. Qiyamul Layl is the best prayer after the obligatory prayers. And this is based on the hadith that Al-Imam Muslim narrated in hadith Abi Huraira, that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Afdalu Siyami, the best fasting, ba'da Ramadan, after the month of Ramadan, is Shahrullahi al-Muharram. The best fasting after Ramadan is what? Shahrullah al-Muharram, the month of Allah. Muharram, that month is the best fasting after Ramadan. Wa afdalu salati, and the best prayer is ba'd al-fariida, after the person prays the obligatory prayers, is what? Salatul layli, the night prayer. And Ibn Khuzaymah, the wording that he transmitted is Salatu fi jawfi al-layl, the prayer at midnight, Qiyamul Layl. Then Qiyamul Layl is the best act, the best after the obligatory prayers. Inshallah ta'ala, my beloved brothers and sisters, my beloved brothers, this is an episode of a series that we're starting where we speak about fiqh Qiyamul Layl. Tomorrow, inshallah ta'ala, we're going to speak about the names that Qiyamul Layl has. Asma'uha, how many names does it have? What is the difference between Taraweeh? What does Witr mean? What does Qiyamul Layl mean? What does Salatul Layl mean? What are all of these names? What do they mean? We'll speak about that. The second thing that we'll speak about is Awqatuha, the times that the Qiyamul Layl is prayed. The third thing that we're going to be speaking about is Adabuha, the etiquette of praying it. The fourth is Fadluha, the virtues that have come regarding it. The fifth is Ahwalu Ba'd al-Salaf fi Salatul Layl. We're going to speak about some of the action and the way that the Salaf al-Salih, the pious predecessors, used to pray at night, and their etiquette, inshallah ta'ala. Also, we'll speak about ayyuhuma afdal, which one is more virtuous. Salatul jama'ah, to pray in a congregational prayer in Qiyamul Layl, furada, or should we pray singular? And everyone should pray by themselves. Which one is better? We'll speak about that. Adaduha, the amount of raka'at that the Qiyamul Layl is, we'll speak about that inshallah ta'ala. We'll also speak about afdalul adad, what is the best amount that a person should pray. And last but not least, masail manthura mutanawi'ah. We'll speak about other masail and other important issues. Every day inshallah ta'ala is going to be 10 to 15 minutes inshallah ta'ala, no longer than that. Something very small that you can take with you and that you can understand inshallah ta'ala. And was finished today, bi-idhnillahi al-kareem, for that. We'll just start aqiyam. BarakAllahu. Jazakallahu khairan.
exactly how to record that.